Hey everyone, today I'm going to go through snippets from HubSpot and what are snippets and how they can be used. So in HubSpot, we have this little, if you're using the sales extension that I've gone through in one of my last videos, you can see that we have this little snippets button when we're creating a new email in Gmail, and this is the same in Outlook as well. We can click on this, and from here we can actually click and add in some text, a little bit snippets, let's call them, snippets of text, little kind of templates of text that help you save time so you don't have to type things or remember things as easily. So I've created three examples here. We've got an opening snippet like this, and in this case you can see it automatically adds the person's first name based on the email address and the details in HubSpot. Then we've got this text which we can edit. It's also added the person's company, their company name that we have in HubSpot as well. We can then jump in and add in another snippet with the pricing info like this, and you can see you can include bold, and you can also include links in this text as well. You can do quite a lot with formatting. And then we can have another snippet for the close like this, and we can use these snippets anywhere in HubSpot as well, anywhere that there's a note, place to add a note. So if we're in HubSpot and we're in a particular contact and we're on their page, let's say we're adding a note, or we're adding a call log or a task or meeting log, we can go straight in and you just simply add the little code you've added like this. I'll show you that in a sec, and you can click here and you got your pricing that I put in here. So how do we edit these snippets? You go to conversations and then snippets, and here you can create new snippets like this, and we can also add or edit the existing snippets like this. You click the snippet, we can add in a bit more detail. For example, we could say we could have a link here, make this a link, and then we just go down here, click on link. So we're linking per month text, and we can just say link.com, apply. There we go, we've got our link. So we can do any of this like this. We can easily edit this like this, click save snippet. And then the last thing to mention as well is at the bottom, when you're creating a new snippet or editing a snippet, you can create a little shortcut. And that's what I used before when I added the note. So I just could use the hashtag and then pricing. So I just go like this when I'm in the contact that I'm looking at. And I can just say with the little hash and then PR, and there we go. It's added in like that. You can't use this in Gmail, but you can just simply look it up in Gmail like we did by going snippets like this. So you can use this in multiple different kinds of ways. This is great for saving time, great for making sure that key information is gathered and you have like a process in place, and ensuring people don't waste time, you know, copy pasting from somewhere or trying to remember things or retyping things over and over again. So please feel free to check that out. Let me know if you have any questions about snippets, and I'll be doing another video very soon about the top five ways, smart, different, unusual ways that you can use snippets in your business to help you save time and collect data in a smarter way. So if you'd like to see that and any other videos about HubSpot and Zapier and digital marketing and sales operations and software, please feel free to subscribe. And if you've enjoyed this video, if it's been useful in any way, please like, and of course, add any comments or questions down below. Okay, thanks so much for watching. See you in the next video. Cheers.